Hi, wrestling fans. Bob Cole. Welcome to Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. We've got an extended lineup of stars, an exciting hour in store for you. You're going to see Wahoo McDaniel, Don Morocco. Plus, you're going to see King Kong Mosca and Ninja, the really rough, wild one with his partner, Ivan Koloff. Just great, great action. A lot's been happening. We want to tell you about some of it right now. We want to bring in and introduce to you the new United States Heavyweight Champion, Wahoo McDaniel. Wahoo, congratulations.
Well, you know, it's a good call. You know, it's the thing is the fact that I beat Slaughter on TV, and a lot of people said it was a fluke, and he said it took two men to beat him. And I took the belt in a match, and I proved it was no fluke. I proved to the people he was lying. And, you know, and I'm signed a lot of contracts, and it's kind of upset our schedule for the world's belts now.
Yeah,
and
I was going to say, well, it's presented a little bit of problem, hasn't it, about the tag team tournament?
It really, really has, and, you know, we've talked to him about getting some of the dates set back, some of the towns moved, and it's been kind of turmoil and caused a little dissension in some places.
All right, Wahoo, what you're saying is that you're trying to get the World Tag Team Tournament, the tournament that best four out of seven, delayed a little bit.
I'm trying to. I don't know if we're going to be able to or not, and it's really conflicting
dates. You
know,
that's really terrific. You come to me in Hawaii, and I spent close to $15,000 to move my family and everything to the East Coast here. I won the East Coast Regional, and congratulations on winning the United States title. I know. You deserve it. You went to Slaughter, but originally I just thought that I was here for the World Tag Team Championship, not to fool around with a bunch of other belts. You got your belt, that's fine.
All right, that's your partner, Don Morocco, Wahoo. I see it's caused a little dissension right there, it looks like.
Well, you know, I didn't have any idea that I was going to be in here and win this belt, and it caused a little dissension. You know, he's screaming, I'm making money, he's not, and he's waiting back in the wings for the World's Tag Team Tournament to come about, and I've got several commitments with this belt, and like I said, it's causing some dissension, and you know, it's embarrassing to me because we have been friends for a while, a long time, and you know, we're a good team together, and I just hate to see anything come between us.
Wahoo, I do too, and I hope that's going to work out for you.
I think it will.
Again, congratulations to you, the new United States Heavyweight Champion, fans, Wahoo McDaniel. All right, we'll be back. We'll have action in the ring right after we take this brief time out. All right, fans, in the ring, the bell. We're ready now with tag team action right here. Don Morocco and his partner, Wahoo McDaniel, against Juan Reynosa and Bill White. And it's Reynosa and Morocco as the match gets underway. Morocco and Wahoo McDaniel, I'm sure all you fans are aware of the Western winners in our tag team, World Tag Team Tournament. Morocco, at the beginning of our program, a little bit upset, a little bit disturbed with the fact that Wahoo McDaniel is the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion. And Wahoo says that new championship belt, of course, is interfering with a tag team tournament. And he's asked the NWA to delay that tournament at best four out of seven series against the Eastern winners, which, of course, are Ole Anderson and Stan Hansen. Wahoo has asked for that to be delayed, and that has upset, according to Wahoo, a lot of people, caused some dissension, and it certainly looks like it's caused some dissension between Morocco and Wahoo. Wahoo McDaniel in the ring right now as we get a break as Reynosa backs away as Wahoo's in the ropes. By the same token, I know that all you wrestling fans are delighted with the fact that Wahoo is the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion, having defeated Sergeant Slaughter for that belt. White now stretching and reaching across the rope, trying to make a tag. As Wahoo's applying the pressure now to the arm, trying to keep him away, and just an inch or so away. Very, very close was White to making the tag. Now after the tag, here comes Bill White in. Wahoo McDaniel still out near the center of the ring. And fans, as we mentioned, a tremendous lineup of world-class wrestling stars during this hour. Tremendous drop kick, Don Morocco. Really floored White. Well, that one has him up high now. Power slam. You're looking, of course, at the Western winners for the World Tag Team Tournament. Also, you're going to see the prizes of Sergeant Slaughter, Don Canoda and Jim Nelson. King Kong Mosca is going to be here along with Ninja and Koloff, and Ninja and Koloff will be teamed together. A tag. Wahoo quickly takes White down with a headlock. White had him stacked up only for a count of one. Fans, also, we're going to be talking a little later with Roddy Piper. And again, I hope all of you fans had an opportunity to see what Roddy Piper did to Jerry Briscoe and to Jerry Briscoe's knee last week. When Roddy Piper came off of the top ropes, when Jerry Briscoe had the knee lock in. Wahoo with a slant chop coming out of the corner. Reneso's a big heavy one, and Wahoo quickly gets over to make the tag. Here's the wild man, Don Morocco. Reneso with a headlock. Right out of it comes Morocco. Good leg takedown. And we were mentioning Roddy Piper, Jerry Briscoe. We're going to have a tape of that. And if you missed it and you didn't see it, or if you saw it, I'm sure you're going to want to see it again, too, as we get an opportunity to see and look again at just what Roddy Piper did to Jerry Briscoe's knee. Wahoo now with the leg. Reneso crawling, gets through the ropes. Wahoo will have to break it. First, he just drives that knee right into the mat. Well, I must say that during this tag team match, if there is any dissension between Wahoo and Morocco over the fact that Wahoo is the new U.S. champ, it is not evident in this match. It has not surfaced, at least to this point. They are still continuing to work very, very well as a tag team. Reneso now, with his hand up under the chin, is going to make the ropes again. And now, with Wahoo in the ropes, is going to drag him down to the corner for the tag and hold him there while White comes through. A couple of good hard right hands by White, now with a chin lock. Front face, and he's got good pressure to it right now. And I just noticed Sergeant Slaughter just walked into the studio, standing down near the ring, watching Wahoo McDaniel in the ring. Tremendous chop from Wahoo as White comes off the ropes. One, two, oh! And here is Slaughter going to pull White. Pulls White into the ropes and under the ropes. And here's White now, gets Wahoo from behind. Slaughter, the former U.S. champion, in watching Wahoo, interfered right there when he grabbed White and just drug him over to the ropes. Reneso now with Wahoo into the ropes again. Hard elbow. Wahoo with a tomahawk chop. Here comes Morocco. Atomic drop on Slaughter. Slaughter took that Marine belt off from around his waist and just hit Wahoo with it in the corner. And Morocco now is going to be double teamed in the corner while Wahoo is down and gone after Slaughter. And Morocco is really going to have to pay for this. As he tries to fight his way out of the corner, Wahoo took out after Slaughter and left Morocco. And here comes Morocco for the tag and there's nobody there. White out of the eyes. Morocco came over to tag Wahoo. Nobody at home in the corner. Wahoo had gone. And that was a really pained expression on the face of Morocco when he dove into that corner and there was nobody there. And again, he's double teamed. Now Wahoo's back in the corner. Well, there's no way of telling what's running through Morocco's mind right now. Knee lift from Reneso. And they've got Morocco in trouble. Back into the corner. Hard right hand. Morocco to the eyes. Hard slam, and now he's going to go over. And he not only tags Wahoo, he almost knocks his hand off. And Morocco, after the tag, walks out. Morocco now is going to leave Wahoo. Reneso with a tag to White. Good takedown by Wahoo McDaniel. But Wahoo in there now against the two all by himself. There goes White out. Well, Morocco really read it wrong, fans. He was sure that Wahoo had deserted him when Wahoo went charging out after Slaughter. Well, here, double team being held in a corner by Reynoso. Big right hands from White. Remember, Don Morocco, Wahoo's partner, has left. He's left the ring. Wahoo now has got to take them both on. The tag from White. In and off the ropes, the elbow floors Wahoo, and now here comes Wahoo over to his corner, looking up in his corner, and nobody there. Tremendous chop as Wahoo fights his way back again now in the corner. Tiny hook shot. He's having to take them both out at this point. Flores Reynoso, who makes the tag to White. Here's a fresh man now in after Wahoo. Down from his shoulder as White again goes off of the ropes. Another quick tag to Reynoso. Another fresh man. They're going to tag and they're going to switch on him. Just as Wahoo gets up, shot again. He caught White coming off the ropes. One, two, three. Wahoo and his family took them both on and pinned White. After Morocco had left, Wahoo McDaniel pinning Bill White for the count of three. Very, very quickly with that chop, he floored him. Here goes Wahoo down. Watch now as Reynoso is quickly going to go back for a tag. Here comes White into the ring. When he comes off of the ropes, here's the chop. That started his downfall and the end of it right there. One, two, three. And our winner, Wahoo McDaniel. And fans, right here, Wahoo, I got to ask you. You know, I'm sure your partner thought that you had left him up there in the ring when you went out after Slaughter. Then he's gone, and you're up there by yourself against the two.
Well, like I said, the U.S. belt's brought up a little difficulty between the two of us. And I just can't believe the man would walk out and leave me. Evidently, he didn't see when Slaughter hit me that belt.
That's right.
And, you know, I'm not going to stand there and let the man hit me and not do something about it. It's a misunderstanding. I just hope it can be patched up. That's all I can say.
All right, now talking about Slaughter. Slaughter, sure. Former U.S. champ, Wahoo.
Well, you know, a lot of people, when I was wrestling on TV here, and I beat him in a non-title match, he said, well, is he that good? Can Wahoo beat him again? Well, I wrestled him three times. I beat him once. I wrestled a draw with him, and I beat him for the belt. So that remains to be seen. I'm the U.S. heavyweight champion. Might have been a lucky night for me. The man is a great wrestler. I'm not taking anything away from him. But I say one thing, he'll have a lot harder time getting it back than he did holding it. And I'd just like to show the people a little cut from a match that we had recently here.
All right, that's right. Wahoo, we got a tape of this, and this is you and Slaughter in a match.
That's right.
Looks like he's got that Cobra clutch on you, Wahoo.
He got the Cobra clutch on me. I managed to battle out, fight, and got out of there. I knew when the man gets your best hold on you, then you better do something to get off of here. He's going to beat you. So I fought my way out of there. I managed to get outside the ring. You know the new rules now, there's no count out, so I knew I was in good shape. Right here you can see I'm fighting. I battle him now, right here. I managed to throw
him.
Well, you know, there's no disqualifications. It works in our way and it works in the other guy's way. Sometimes I think it works better their way than our way. And we've been fighting for a long time. This is like a 30-40 minute match here. We're both tired, we're both beat. You know, he's fighting to get his title back here. Yeah.
Well,
and
right here, you were in that clutch for some time, too, Wahoo.
That's right. Before I broke it here, I was in that clutch for probably 5 minutes, six. And believe me, it's you can say anything you want to. Cobra hold is a form of a choke hold or type sleeper hold. And it cuts your wind off. And believe me, it's hard to come back from ever when you get one of those put on you.
He was coming after you right there, and that chop stopped him right dead, Wahoo.
Well, it was a brutally hard-fought battle, believe me. You can look at my head and see all the cuts and stuff I've got. I'm bleeding there. And I'm hitting the man as hard as I can. And I'm having a hard time knocking the man down. Most opponents I hit, they go down. This man's fighting for his life. I'm fighting for my life. And you'll be surprised how far down you can reach and get something. As you can see right there, he got a hip toss on me and he got an elbow.
Well, Wahoo, he's a big, strong, powerful man, too. Ooh, he got a count. Look, almost looked like three right there, Wahoo. Very, very close.
Well, here's what you call reaching down and getting something, and that's guts. And you can see right there, we've had a long, hard battle. This is like 30, 40 minutes deep in the match. And I'm beginning to wonder if I'm going to be able to retain the belt.
Well, again, he got the count of two.
Well, that's right. I'm fighting for everything I've got. I know he's fighting. I know he wants that belt back, and he knows I want to keep it.
Wahoo's staying right on top of you. He is really trying to just pound you in the submission here.
Same hold twice, and the man should never do that. Just go for the same hold twice in one match when you're hurting. I was waiting for it. I trapped him, and I got the backslide on him out of the hip toss, which a lot of people can't do that. But if you can do it and wait for the right movement, you got to wait till the man makes a mistake, and that's what I did.
All right, Wahoo, you're still down on the mat. He's lost the match, but look at Slaughter right here.
Right. You know, he won't give up. He's frustrated here, and the man is frustrated now, and he's going to try everything he can to get the title back. And with these new rules we got, believe me, you never know what's going to happen. But I have the title, and I'm going to defend it against everybody. And Slaughter can get in line, I'll sure defend it against him. I'm not afraid.
Wahoo, again, congratulations to you. Wahoo McDaniel.
I'm sorry about what happened in the ring between Morocco and I.
All right, fans, we'll be back. We'll have more action right here, right after we take time out for this message. The ring bell, and here we go now with single action as we got Ken Timms in against Terry Gibbs in the ring right now. I am still just really befuddled what happened with Don Morocco and Wahoo McDaniel. You really hate to see anything like that come between two men who have wrestled together and been friends for so long, but you can certainly see how it happened to Morocco when he went over to make a tag, not knowing that Wahoo had taken off after Slaughter. Hip toss by Ken Timms, holding right onto the arm is Gibbs. He goes and rolls right on through it, keeps that arm. Takedown now, knee drop. Again, right on the arm, and the arm muscle goes back to the wrist and the arm and is going to stay right with that arm. Remember, you're going to see Sergeant Slaughter's privates. And these two guys have turned out to be every bit as mean as Sergeant Slaughter. That's Jim Nelson, Don Chernovitz. The big man, King Kong Mosca. Good leg takedown by Gibbs as Timms was coming off of the rope. Full speed ahead. Again, he's gone back to the arm. And again with that knee drop. Also, Ninja Ivan Koloff in a tag team match against the Samoans. That'll be something to see. Again, Gibbs with the arm. The elbow drop again of the arm after getting a couple of knees in it, and he's staying right with that left arm as Timms is going to back him to the ropes now. Well, he left himself open for those forearms, and that one right up beside the jaw. And an elbow coming off of the rope. Quickly kicks out even before a count. Look at Timms, though, quickly back on the attack with a headlock and clawing at the eyes. Suplex. And he's going to cover him and hook the leg, and oop, did he kick out? Yes, sir. Only a count of two. In the stretch. Terry Gibbs has got Timms in the stretch. One, two, three, and he's going to pin him right there very quickly. A quick turn of events for Terry Gibbs. Watch as he sends Timms hard into the ropes, and when he comes off, he's going to come off right into the stretch. The grapevine with the shoulders to the mat, one, two, three, and it's all over right at this point with our winner, Terry Gibbs.
Let's take time for this commercial message about the Mid-Atlantic wrestling events coming up in your area.
Fans, again, as we say, it's been an exciting hour so far. In our opening match, we really saw something happen with Don Morocco and Wahoo McDaniel. As Wahoo, who is the new U.S. champ, and Morocco was a little bit disturbed about that at the beginning of the program, saying that Wahoo now is not going to be able to complete all of the commitments that he thought they had for the World Tag Team Tournament and for the World Tag Team Belts. Not only this, but when he went over to tag Wahoo, Wahoo was out after Sergeant Slaughter. And talking about Sergeant Slaughter, Here comes two of his privates in right here, Don Canoto, Jim Nelson, Juan Reynosa.
You got that right. You got Private Nelson and Private Canoto, new Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions. We've been out here training hard with Sergeant Slaughter. Sergeant Slaughter's been training hard. All this mouth about Wahoo McDaniels. Pretty soon it's not going to be any Wahoo McDaniels.
Wahoo McDaniels, the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
That was a fluke. I don't know how in the world that happened. Sergeant Slaughter is going to get it back, and he's going to keep it back. Just as long, only thing we got in our mind is keeping these belts just long enough till we get the World Tag Team Championships. And that's exactly what we got in mind, right?
I believe it. There's no way that Wahoo could beat Sergeant Slaughter. I sat at ringside.
We saw it on tape.
I don't care what you saw. I sat at ringside through a lot of his matches, and this has happened to be one of the greatest wrestlers I've ever seen, and it was a fluke as far as I'm concerned. Wahoo McDaniel couldn't beat Sergeant Slaughter. The next time there's a title match and they get in the ring, Wahoo McDaniel's going to go down, and Sergeant Slaughter will have that U.S. title back around his waist.
How many times has Wahoo beaten him now? Three times.
Sergeant Slaughter has never lost a match to Wahoo McDaniels or anybody. There's nobody out there who can beat Sergeant Slaughter. There's nobody out there who can beat Private Nelson and Private Canoe. We're the best tag team around here, and Sergeant Slaughter's the best individual champion around here. And I'll guarantee you, it won't be long until that belt's back around his waist, and we're going to keep our belts for a long time.
You're cheering him on.
Oh, of course I am. What else could I want to do? That's right. Sergeant Slaughter is going to really get wild with stuff. And I'm here for one thing also. That's to win here, Charlie. And, baby, I'm coming, and I'm going to get all of you.
Goodbye, Wahoo. Back to the happy hunting ground where you belong. You're on your way out, baby. Wahoo Squahoo on his way out. Happy hunting ground to you, baby.
All right, fans. That's it right here at ringside. Fans, we'll be back with more action right after we take this brief timeout. Fans, Johnny Weaver right here ringside. Johnny?
Well, Bob, I just want to take a few seconds because Jake Roberts and I was supposed to wrestle Sergeant Slaughter's recruits, Private Nelson and Private Kernodle. Now, the incident happened, you know, when things are going around, animosities happen. Jake Roberts will not be here tonight. We got a film to show you why. And a match in Greensboro happened between the Boogeyman Valiant, Jake Roberts, Ninja, and Koloff. And we're going to show you why Jake won't be here tonight, but I'll have another partner in there against Kernodle. There it is. You see him, Koloff and
Valiant. It looked like just slammed Valiant right into the chair.
Right, there. Now this was end of the match, 10 or 15 minutes. You see Jake laid out right there. Off the rope come Ninja, across Jake. Jake's foot was on the ropes right there.
And here's Valiant too, Johnny.
And they got almost to, the Ninja went back to Roberts right here, but Valiant's taking care of Koloff. You know, he was awful close to Koloff's TV belt.
That's right.
And he's gonna follow Koloff right out of the ring. And here's Jake in the ring now with Ninja getting that knee lift right there. Caught it real good with that knee. You know that knee is Jake's patented offensive weapon. Busy on the outside with Koloff.
Valiant's right out there with Koloff. He's really going at Koloff all this time. Oh, and Roberts
Jake
couldn't make it to Ninja.
Trying to get up, they're both still groggy. Ninja out from that knee and Jake from the beating he's taken before. Valiant has chased Koloff towards the dressing room right here. It leaves Jake in there. And right there's a big tackle. They both were staggered.
Looks like they're both out at this point. Roberts again is trying to cover him, Johnny.
Only two right there. The referee, Sonny Fargo. Jake gets ready. He's got that knee loaded again. And right there, he got that spray right in the eyes. And that's why Jake will not be my partner in the match coming up right here. You see that spray, and he's in pain from that chemical. It burned his eyes. But here's the boogie man right back in the ring. He's got Ninja. Big suplex right there.
And covers him, John.
And we had a winner at this point.
Roberts, as you say, he's got it right in the eye.
The boogie man's back over there to check Jake. And he gets hit with a chair by Ivan Koloff. And then Koloff is right back in the ring. Look, he's got that steel chair. And he goes to work on a Jimmy Valiant right here with that chair. And of course, there's a lot of animosity between both of these wrestlers already.
They both now after Valiant. Both of them on Valiant.
Anderson in there also, you know, the three of them.
Holding him, that's right.
Jake three is injured from the spit. We got the boogeyman right here. Yeah.
wanna let me tell you something, baby. Come on, make me smart and sweet. Ivan Cola, Sid Jam, Gene Anderson. We put this thing down. We planted both eyes. We put 13 stitches in my head. I don't care about myself, man. I don't care about myself, but I do care about my partners.
So let's go to the ring.
Come on, Mike.
That's the bell, fans. Johnny Weaver and his partner now, Mike Davis, against Private Knodel. It's Davis and Knodel as the match gets underway. And let me remind you again, this is a continuation of the match. When Johnny Weaver and Jake Roberts were taking on Knodel and Nelson, the time expired, the time ran out. This is the first time on television that the new experimental rule of the NWA has gone into play. That is, that a match has got to end with a winner. When time expired, the match was to continue. And Roberts, of course, in the meantime, hurt. And Weaver had to get him a new partner, so that's where we are right now. Mike Davis and Johnny Weaver, the continuation of the match. Knodel down hard from that atomic drop out of the corner. Here is Weaver, flying head scissors. Again, let me remind all you fans, be sure and let us know just what you think of the new NWA rule, and that is that a match has got to end with a winner. Just how you're liking it and what you think about it. So far, we've had a tremendous amount of mail, and all of it has been in favor of the new rule. Knodel now with a tag to Nelson, trying to get Weaver and hold him in and double team him. Johnny Weaver very, very quickly got out of that corner. Also, let me remind you, you saw what Ninja and Ivan Koloff did to Jake Roberts and how they went after Jimmy Valiant. We're going to see Ninja and Koloff together as a tag team a little later in the program. Weaver with a big foot really does stun Jim Nelson. He's got Knodel hanging in the ropes. Knodel almost went off head first. Out near the center of the ring, Weaver with a headlock. Nelson reaches up and gets a handful of hair. Weaver now, still with a headlock. Hard now, the ropes back and goes to the corner quickly for a tag. All right, let me get you a mic right here. David Crockett.
We're going to stop the match. We're going to have him ring the bell. Go ahead and ring the bell. We're going to go to commercial break. We've got to go ahead and go now. We are going to have a winner. We're going to come back with this match right after the commercial break. Right after all, right. We have all these commercial
okay,
breaks.
Man. We're going to stop the match right here. As all four of them are at it, right after we say timeout for this commercial. Fans, and with us right here ringside now, King Kong Muska.
I'll tell you one thing, at 320 pounds, King Kong Muska would get rid of this match in about a minute and a half. Everybody's scared to sign a contract against King Kong Muska. Well, I'm going to show you what I can do to get rid of people in maybe a minute, maybe 2 minutes. So where's Wahoo? Where's Briscoe? Where's Piper? Where's Anderson? Where's anybody? Because King Kong Muska is going to show you how I walk and talk and do exactly what I want to. I'll guarantee you it doesn't take me 10 minutes to win a match.
Ivan Koloff.
He's the man with a lot of guts, you know. That's something, you know, this value, this boogeyman. I'm convinced now that he is crazy in the head. We've got rid of this Roberts, though. This Jake Roberts snake. You don't see him around no more. I understand. Yeah. He's in the hospital. Yeah. Yeah. Intensive damage to his eyes. Well, that was our intention, to get rid of this boogeyman, this Jimmy Valiant, because I know his obsession of getting my TV belt away from me. But it's not going to happen. They say I bring chairs in the ring, that I run, that I do everything. They're throwing fines at Ninja and myself. But this is only the beginning. If it takes it, I'm going to go in that ring with my chain. Yes, I'm going to stop you, Valiant, one way or another. And this is going to be it.
U.S. Champ Sergeant Slaughter, former U.S. Champ Sergeant Slaughter. Wahoo McDaniel now wearing that belt.
Yeah, Wahoo McDaniel, the new U.S. heavyweight champion of the world, but he doesn't have a friend in the world. Wahoo McDaniel, you're finding out that there are no friends in wrestling. They're all a bunch of rats, and you're the biggest rat of all. Going around and telling everybody that you beat Sergeant Slaughter. The film showed that my shoulder was up. You're doctoring the tapes. You step in the ring anytime you want, especially right here in this town, and I'll beat you for that title.
All right, fans, that's it right here ringside. All right, fans, after the timeout, the bell, and here we go now again with a continuation of the match between Private Canoda, Private Nelson, Johnny Weaver, Mike Davis, and remember, we've got to have a winner. Well, this match now has been going on literally for weeks. And we had an opportunity to hear from Ivan Koloff that he and Ninja are gonna do to Valiant again what they did to Jake Roberts, what they did to Valiant before. Canoda with the elbow. Weaver down, ready to give him the back flip. Had him all set for it. Canoda saw that and came with a powerful elbow smash right to the back of the neck. Weaver down on the floor in trouble now. Almost out. Off of the ropes. Double thrust. Again floors Weaver. They tag and they're going to double team him. As they hold him in the corner, here comes Davis. Davis now going to be sent back out of the ring. Weaver again caught in the corner through the legs. Quickly over for the tag. Here comes Mike Davis. And remember, fans, there's got to be a winner in the match. Back card. High in the air with Nelson. And Davis tripped as he tried to get over Nelson. One, two, one, only a count of two. Canoda made it in just a nick of time. Here's Canoda. Off of the rope, clotheslined him. And now he's going to just put Nelson right over him. Covers him with Nelson. As he clotheslines Davis off the top. Boom! And Weaver can't get there in time. What a turn of events that one was. Nelson and Davis both were hurt. When Davis got to his feet, Canoda clotheslined him off of the top rope. Now, with a knee to the back of Weaver, sends him right through the ropes, and they're both now attacked by Davis. Nelson and Canoda after Davis. When Weaver gets up on the apron, Canoda quickly goes back after him. The two guys are going wild. As they stomp and kick away now at Mike Davis, who's down in the ring. He's at their mercy. Weaver out on the floor. At the moment, cannot give him any help. And here comes Canoda again after Weaver. Knee to the back. They continue to stomp and maul Mike Davis. Here comes Ron Ritchie. Ritchie in to help him. Here comes Weaver. Canoda takes Ritchie down. Weaver goes after Nelson. And Canoda and Ritchie are really going at each other. Weaver and Nelson outside of the ring are going at it. What a wild time. Through the ropes goes Canoda. Nelson trying to grab him and help him. He's trying to get him out and get him out of the studio.
Well, it took Ron Ritchie in to give a hand to Mike Davis and to Johnny Weaver. What a wild time and a wild finish. And look at Knodel here and Ritchie in slow motion as they really go at each other. It was a wild one and a wild time right there, but our winners are going to be Don Knodel, Private Nelson.
Fans of ringside, Roddy Piper, very sneaky, very dirty trick you pulled on Jerry Briscoe.
Well, that's about three times I've heard you say, very sneaky, very dirty trick I pulled on Jerry Briscoe. You see, the thing is, there's all kinds of people that come up here and talk and say, well, I hurt this guy in Chicago. I hurt this guy in Minneapolis. I hurt this guy in Iowa. I hurt this guy in Biafra. But you see, when Roddy Piper wants to do something, he does it right here on television, national television. Mid-Atlantic goes all over the place just to see. You see, that's why wrestlers fear Roddy Piper. That's why Jack Briscoe knees tremble when he hears the word Roddy Piper. All of a sudden, his little brother's all hurt. That's why Wahoo McDaniels trembles. That's why Don Morocco trembles. That's why every last one of them is afraid of Roddy Piper. And can you blame him? Because would you want to fight me? Of course you wouldn't want to fight me, would you?
No,
and that's how everybody feels, because I'm just the cream on your mashed potatoes, brother. I'm just what I want to be. You see, there's nobody better than me.
Let me say, we've got a tape of that. I think the fans ought to see that again. I want everybody to see exactly what you did.
I'd like to see him too.
Fans, let's watch this right
Check
now.
Check it out.
Here it is. Watch this. Here's Jerry Briscoe in his match.
Oh, he's doing
great. No reason for Roddy Piper to interfere at all here.
He's doing great. You see, no reason for Roddy Piper to interfere. What a bunch of baloney. You see, these guys have been mouthing off, saying how great they are, saying what I am, talking about how great their figure four is. Here he is taking advantage of a fella who I don't really care about.
Tony Russo.
Tony Russo. Aw.
Right, watch him when he gets his figure four on.
Okay, let's watch him when he gets his figure four on. Nice move. The only thing is, you see, I have the counter to the figure four. That's the difference between, we're talking side. What we're talking about is Roddy Piper. We're not talking about any kind of goofball in the alley. I have got the counter to this. Jerry Briscoe coming
here.
Well,
they're still locked up. Watch right here. Off of that
top
rope. Right down on the knee.
Yes, I guess so, right down the knee. Look at that Fargo trying to get in my way. You see, that's why nobody gets in my way. And all of a sudden, Jack Briscoe comes out a roaring and a raving like a lion. But you notice he doesn't come out when I'm there. You notice he doesn't come out when I'm standing in the ring. And all of a sudden, Jack Briscoe's down there, and he's holding on to his little brother, and his little brother's leg is all mangled thing. And you know what? There were these humongous tears crying out of Jack Briscoe's eyes. There's Jerry Briscoe. He's crying. There's Tony Russo. He's crying. And so what I'm trying to say is the only guy that's got any substance amongst the whole batch of us is me. You see, because I don't have to fear nobody. I'm starting to take them on two at a time. I'm hurting people all over the place. And you know why I'm hurting people? Because I'm sick and tired of people picking on me. People backstabbing on me. Did you see me come out there? I look like Superman. I was flying. You see, that's why I sounds like thunder and I moves like lightning, Mr. Briscoe. You come out here and say you can have a shot at this title anytime you want to, but you are lying to the people because I want it and you won't give it to me. But as I've said before, ever since you've been this high, you wanted to grow up to be a great wrestler. Well, Mr. Briscoe, I've said it before, you should have concentrated on growing up to be a man.
Let's take time for this commercial message about the Mid-Atlantic wrestling events coming up in your area.
All right, fans, and it's been a wild and woolly one so far. And again, you got to look at that film of exactly what happened to Jerry Briscoe when Roddy Piper came off of that top rope when Jerry had that figure four leg lock in on Tony Russo. And, of course, it was Jerry's knee. And Jack Briscoe has a debt to pay Roddy Piper, and there's no doubt he's going to pay him. Ron Ritchie right here, Ron. I tell you, if you hadn't gotten in there, I don't know what would have happened with the privates in there earlier.
I'd like to say one thing. Knodel, you couldn't make it. You had to go on the other way. You couldn't make it like a man. You had to turn. Well, let me tell you something, Don Knodel, we traveled a lot of miles together. We drank some beer together. We were good friends at one time. But that friendship now, it's all out the window. It's all finished. It's all done. Knodel, I can tell you, don't turn your back.
Terry Gibbs, right here. Terry, very, very impressive win for you.
Thank you very much. You know, in the past territories I've been into before, I've had to prove myself, and this is going to be the same way. I'm coming in here, and I'm going to have to prove myself to all the people. You're not giving anything in this business, and you got to take all you can, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. I do exactly what this shirt says. Wrestlers do it on the mat, and that's exactly what I do. I do it on the mat.
I tell you, and you're going to have to do it here because the competition right here, nowhere are you going to find it like you do right here, Terry.
Yes, sir. No matter where you go to, I've been to Japan, Mexico, all over. This is the place they're talking about, right here. Right
well,
here.
And you see some of the things that are going on. Now you're aware of what the privates did earlier and that involved Ron. You saw what Roddy Piper did to Jerry Briscoe, also that this Ninja and Koloff, what they've been doing to guys like Jake Roberts and to Jimmy Valiant. So this is the type of thing you got to put up with, really.
Yes, sir. Well, I'm looking forward to all the competition, and I just met Ron Ritchie, and I like to say, Ron, anytime he would need any help, I'm more than welcome to help out.
So you'd like to get in there with some tag team action,
sure,
right?
Sure would.
What about that, Ron?
Well, Terry, right now I got one thing on my mind, and that's Don Knuddle. But once that's all taken care of, Terry and I will be more than happy to team up as in a combination. We got a lot in common, and I know Terry, he's got a tremendous background behind him. He's known nationwide for his wrestling ability, and I'll just be much
happy. All right, fans,
happy.
That's it right here at ringside. And we'll be back with more right after we take this brief time out. All right, fans, in the ring right now, you're looking at the Samoans, and we're looking for Ninja and Ivan Koloff. As Ivan Koloff and Ninja now are supposed to go in a tag team match against the Samoans. And here's a referee, but still, no Ivan Koloff and no Ninja. Well, Koloff was out earlier doing a lot of bragging about what he and Ninja were going to do. And here now,
this is our corner. Get over your corner.
Ninja, Ivan Koloff in the ring. Wild combination right here. Our own record as really hurting and punishing the opponents. And Ninja, more than once now, has gone to the eyes with something that he gets into the eyes of the opponent. So now he tells Koloff to move away. Ooh, and there's that green whatever it is that Ninja blows out. The Samoans, big, strong, powerful team, both of them huge, muscular men, and they go right at Ninja in that headlock. Ninja with the arm and the takedown. This man can move, and this man can really wrestle. You put that with some of the other things that he does and how wild he is in the ring, and anything can happen to him. Ninja, who is really a wild one, can really get around a ring. Really moves well. A tremendous amount of wrestling ability and knowledge is going to take him to the corner now for Koloff. Makes a tag. Russian bear Ivan Koloff. Elbow. Well, it's been a while, when fans, and that we knew. When you have wrestlers around like Roddy Piper, like Sergeant Slaughter, like Private Nelson and Private Knuddle, you know that it's got to be a wild time, and that's exactly what happened. Ninja with that chop as a Samoan is off of the rope. He got him right in the throat with it. Again now with that chop to the back, in the back of the neck. And the neck muscle. Power slam, quickly now to Koloff for the tag. They've got him hurt. And Koloff again goes right to the arm. Backbreaker, and again a backbreaker from Koloff. And a count of two, and a Samoan gets a save, does he? No, he does not. It was three. Well, I thought it was two. The referee said, yes, it was three. All right, the referee with that count of three. One, two, three, after a couple of backbreakers from Ivan Koloff. And our winners, Ninja and Ivan Koloff over the Samoans. Fans, right now, Jack Briscoe, Paul Jones. Jack, first of all, I got Roddy Piper was out really blowing a little earlier now about Jerry and about you.
Well, I'll tell you what, Roddy Piper, I'm going to hold this thing out in front of you. I know this is what's killing you, is the fact that I took your belt. I know that's why you tried to hurt my little brother. I know that's why you tried to put him out of wrestling for life. The doctor still don't know whether he's going to be able to return to the ring.
I was going to ask you about his knee,
Jack. He's under doctor's care. All the ligaments were torn. The cartilages were torn. The doctors don't know whether he'll be able to return to wrestling or not. Big Roddy Piper jumps off the top rope on two men and hurts two men. I've been all around the world, Piper. I know you're a tough man. I know you're a backstabber, too. I've been around the world. I'm at the best. This is what you want. This is what's eating at you, Piper. This is what you can't stand. I've got the Mid-Atlantic Championship, not you. So any time, Piper, this is right here for you. Any time you're mad enough to come and get it, because I'm going to take the responsibility upon my shoulders to repay you for what you've done to my brother.
I tell you, Jack. Paul?
You know, Jack and I discussed it. You know, Jerry's a very close friend of mine, just as Jack is here. And I tell you one thing, when you do something like that, it hurts deep. And I know exactly what Jack's talking about. They've gone too far. Piper, you've abused wrestlers in here for a long time, and it's going to stop. Slaughter, I don't know who you think you are, but you're coming to an end pretty soon, too. Mosca is another one. Khan, and the list goes on. But there's one thing I want to say right now. I'm behind Jack 100%. Ole Anderson's no better. One way or the other. The people want to see justice done, and we've got to get out there and we've got to do it. We'll catch them in the arenas, we'll catch them in the coliseums, but I guarantee you one thing, Jack, I'm behind you and we'll catch them.
Well, I appreciate that very much, Paul. Roddy Piper, right here it is. Anytime you're man enough, anywhere, anytime, I'll tell you, you're not going to be safe anywhere, Piper, because I'm going to get you anytime I see you anywhere.
All right, fans, that's it right here at ringside. That's it for this week. We'll see you next week, and until then, so long for now.
Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling has been furnished to this station for broadcast at this time by Jim Crockett Promotions in exchange for commercial consideration.